A new era has dawned.
A little miracle of technology. The atomic power stations are going up.
We're bombarded with radiation all the time, from everyday objects like a watch.
Most people think that radioactive waste is some kind of glowing green goo, but in actual fact, it looks a little bit like this, black glass. It will be radioactive for hundreds of thousands of years, and this is why we really need to think about its long-term future.
The danger of radioactive waste is here today and goes on tomorrow.
In full operation, it will supply electricity for a million people.
Climate change. The gases blamed for global warming are pumped out in ever bigger quantities.
The window of time to mitigate the climate crisis is shrinking by the day, really.
The problem is how to reduce greenhouse gases.
Nuclear power has a long proven record as a non-fossil energy source.
Nuclear energy is not a solution to climate change.
Nuclear energy has a fraught history. Greeted with optimism in the 1950s, its reputation was clouded by atomic bomb tests and disasters like Chernobyl. But as global leaders work to tackle climate change, nuclear power's allure has come full circle. Once up and running, nuclear power stations emit no carbon dioxide or other greenhouse gases, and nuclear's constant energy generation sets it apart from renewable sources of energy whose output can vary.
For the past 60 years or so, it has provided a very important type of electricity, which we call baseload power. That's the type of electricity that guarantees that 24/7, no matter when you want to flip on or off your light switch, the lights will be there.
The inherent dangers of nuclear energy make it a controversial energy source, and not everyone agrees it's worth the risks it brings.
Nearly all of our nuclear waste is at coastal sites in one way or the other. These are locations that are liable to coastal processes, storm surges, sea level rise. Those are highly vulnerable to the worst impacts of climate change that we can foresee. I'm concerned about the dangers it poses. Accidents can happen and will happen.
In 2011, a devastating earthquake and tsunami in Japan led to meltdown at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear reactor.
As a result of the Fukushima accident, both Japan and Germany, for different reasons, decided to shut down rapidly their national nuclear energy output. They ramped up coal and gas output for a few years after the accident.
Dr. Kurecha's research found that there were health consequences linked to this reduction in the use of nuclear energy, as both countries increased their use of fossil fuels in subsequent years.
As a direct yet unintended consequence of their decision to drastically reduce their nuclear power output after the Fukushima accident, both Japan and Germany together lost the opportunity to prevent over 28,000 air pollution-induced premature deaths that were as a result of fossil fuel power use.
Japan is slowly restoring its nuclear capacity, while Germany has increased its renewable energy output over the past decade, although that was accompanied by a steep rise in energy prices for the public. For countries with nuclear in their energy mix, such as the UK, Finland, and China, constructing efficient new reactors is both expensive and time-consuming. Hinkley Point C, Britain's first nuclear reactor since 1995, will cost £23 billion, at least twice as much as the London 2012 Olympic Games, and this figure continues to rise. Modern nuclear reactors are designed meticulously and built to withstand earthquakes and other threats, including plane crashes. But even the best designed nuclear reactors create radioactive waste, and that needs careful disposal.
In the UK, we have about 4.5 million cubic meters of radioactive waste. The largest portion of this, about 96%, is low-level waste. High-level waste is very high radioactivity material, but we have the smallest volume of this, just less than 1%. The radiation from high-level waste is so intense that if you were to touch it, you'd receive a radiation dose about a million times more than you would receive throughout an entire year just from natural radiation sources. It's extremely high for several thousands, even hundreds of thousands of years. So ideally, where we want to be is in a place where we can isolate those wastes from future populations in a safe way. For example, digging a very deep hole underground and disposing of the waste there forever.
This solution is known as a geological disposal facility, where waste is disposed of between 200 and 1,000 metres below the Earth's surface. Because most people don't like the idea of living next to radioactive waste, it's been very difficult for governments to find a suitable site, let alone start building one. Finland is currently the only country in the world building a permanent underground storage facility for their nuclear waste. Every nation with nuclear power has so far stored its waste in temporary facilities, and those facilities are aging.
I'm not against deep disposal because I think ultimately we'll have to deal with our present waste that way. But that is so far ahead that the problem here and now is safe storage. And all the time we're waiting for the holy grail of a deep disposal facility. The job of that facility is to deal with the massive amounts of nuclear waste that we already have. The idea that we should be piling more and unknown quantities for far further ahead is absolutely ludicrous in my view.
If we don't get our hands on clean energy and rapidly scale them up by as much as possible within the next few decades, then we're leaving a massive burden on future generations. We need to completely decarbonize the electricity sector and ideally also the overall energy sector if we're to avert the worst impacts of the human-caused climate crisis.
As our understanding of the climate crisis deepens and energy demands continue to grow, the necessity that our energy comes from non-fossil fuel sources makes nuclear power hard to ignore. It is expensive and it can be dangerous if safety protocols are not followed. The highly radioactive waste it generates is hugely challenging to store safely. But it also provides a reliable power baseline, keeping the lights from turning off on a cloudy, windless winter evening and meeting countries' energy needs as they transition away from fossil fuels. And that is the nuclear dilemma.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that, be sure to check out these videos next. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button and click the bell to get a notification each time we upload a new video.